Thank you. Don't pay too much attention to the marching round music, because we're bringing you this routine slightly delayed whilst the gymnasts are marching round. So Christina Zwicker didn't have to endure that. Uses that nice switch leap mount to begin her routine. And her score 11.166. Now on the uneven bars, Zofia Kovac with a 14.2 score. And that is up just a fraction from qualification. Dilara Yurdash, 12.166. She's down by just under a tenth. Right, so all of that means at this stage of the competition, it is Romania by a mark over Ukraine. But Ukraine are looking over their shoulder nervously at Hungary. And we already have a clear separation. What looks to be three teams who are chasing for three different positions on the podium, unless something dramatic happens. Well, it's wonderful to have your company. If you are just joining the action, I think I might be just joining the action because I understand you haven't been able to hear me for the first rotation. Hope you enjoyed it. All good things must come to an end. And we move round to the second rotation now. So let us just take stock of how things are. We see Romania leading the way. Then we have Ukraine in second position, a mark shy of that leading score. Then Hungary, they're just 0.4 away from Ukraine. And then we've got already about 6 marks between Hungary and Turkey. So a peloton starting to form. One of the great gymnasts of the Turkish team, Gökçü Uçtaşan, we just saw there watching as her teammates prepare. She's marshalling over a team of 4 16-year-olds. And she's in the arena where she's had her greatest success as a gymnast. Well, Romania are chasing their 8th team title. And we're going to just remind ourselves of some of the work that they produced early on in the competition. This is Silviana Sviringu. Score of 14.2 for her. Polly Hogben here bringing you all of the action from these European Championships of Women's Artistic Gymnastics. Ukraine and Romania and Hungary are very much now in a battle for the podium places. And we still have 3 more rotations of great fun to enjoy here in the Mersin Gymnastics Hall. Cemre Kandurcu will get things underway for Turkey on the balance beam. And we look at Croatia and Czech Republic, the nations who qualified in 5th and 6th positions to this team final. Croatia just made it by a matter of half a mark or so ahead of Luxembourg. And boy, did Luxembourg do a fantastic job. What one has to remind oneself of when looking at a nation like Luxembourg is that they only had 3 gymnasts who had to compete on every single piece, didn't have the luxury of discarding a weak score in qualification, which you can do. 4 compete on each apparatus in qualification, 3 scores count, but in the final there is no buffer zone. So it is of great credit to the gymnasts from Luxembourg that they were so very close to pushing a nation like Croatia out of the team final. We're going to get a little bit of history made to some degree. Ukraine, for example, have never won a team gold. They've won a couple of silver medals. They've won the bronze medal on 3 occasions, all of those some years ago now. Hungary, never won a team medal. Turkey, never won a team medal. Likewise for Croatia and Czech Republic. So we head to the balance beam. Cemre Kenduji of Turkey. She is well versed on the balance beam. She started with a 10.566 on the uneven bars. She's spoken of just how excited she is to be here, to be participating in this competition. It's now about steadying those nerves. And after a tricky start on the uneven bars, can she do that here? Nearly. Was looking quite settled into that routine as well. Not the easiest skill there. It does take a while for a gymnast to really settle into a European Championship final sometimes, and maybe we'll see that with some of the athletes who are less experienced at being in a big competition. It's one of the things that is so interesting. It was evident from the rhythmic gymnastics European Championships, actually, that some athletes who didn't expect to be contending for a medal, once they were, found themselves feeling the pressure even more acutely. Now we look at Ukraine on the uneven bars. Anastasia Motak, reigning national all-around champion. Secure in her close control work to the apparatus, needs to build up the swingfulness a bit more. Really has exacting toe point. Now, real prospect is the 16-year-old athlete. He just turned 16. Cemre Kenduji, 10.833 is her score. So she's down by about half a mark from qualification. Czech Republic competing on the floor, Magdalena Kufalova. Senior international debut for the gymnast based in Liberec. A really interesting routine for Magdalena Kufalova, gymnast who impressed at the Junior National Championships last year when she won the vault title. And certainly contributed a useful score to Czech Republic with her vaulting work in qualification. She will be moving to that piece in just a short while. Romania on the uneven bars with Ioana Stanciulescu. 12.5 was her qualification mark. Gets through the Kachev. Oh, she had real height there and just lost control. Now, let us just keep in mind that the sort of numeracy we're dealing with here, where Romania were leading by a single mark. I'm sure those of you who've been watching gymnastics for some time know all too well that you lose a mark for an unintentional dismount from the apparatus. Does pirouette nice and stably into the Jaeger. Just had to take a few paces with her hands. Has never looked fully comfortable. And this is why one cannot read a great deal into a team final after the first rotation. Maybe not even after the second. Well, she swings round well into a very good dismount. There will be, it is obvious to say, some costly deductions there. We'll come back to that in a moment and take stock of the numbers as we look at Bilge Tahan, who has qualified for Turkey for the balance beam final. She is from Bolu province in the northwest of the country, midway between Ankara and Istanbul. It's been considered for many years a very important site because of its equidistance between those two cities. Now, can she tread a suitably equidistant path along the beam? Just a touch tentative. It was one of her strongest pieces in the qualification process. She was marginally stronger on vault. But we will be seeing Bilge Tahan in the final. Those apparatus finals taking place tomorrow. Now, Diana Varinska of Ukraine on the uneven bars has to feel for Varinska. She has been very unwell lately. She said everything whilst recovering from COVID has been twice as difficult as if training as a gymnast isn't hard enough. It's really hit her. But there is that lovely, difficult work that characterises her on this piece. Now, that's most interesting, because we've already seen that Romania have had a difficulty or two here and there. Is this an opportunity for Ukraine to make up a little ground? On the floor exercise, we carry on looking at the work of Czech Republic, Dominika Ponizilova. A third European Championships for the 18-year-old from Brno. All-around silver medalist at the National Championships. So it was a 12.1 for Bilge Tahan on balance beam. She's down by just a couple of tenths plus from qualification. Now, calm down, everyone. Lisa Jordache of Romania on the uneven bars. So far, so good. Just a small adjustment. Well, well, well. She floats to earth and is looking very impressive. 13.1. She's down a little bit from qualification, just by a few tenths or so. Twice a team champion at the European Championships. Anastasia Bachinska of Ukraine. 11.366 for this in qualification. Is there an opportunity here for Ukraine to pick up some marks, make up some ground? Just lost her leg form, and then as a result, that wasn't the easiest release and catch to make. Jaeger was a little tidier. Does get considerable height going into that dismount and made a momentary loss of stability look very much part of a flourished landing. Pops back up there. Mark of an experienced athlete. On the subject of experienced athletes, right on cue, Göksu Uçtaşan of Turkey has qualified for the floor final. But if you're looking for a tale of a fantastic, inspirational story in gymnastics, you'd do well to look more closely at hers. Blighted by injury, we've got a few athletes who know what that's like at these championships, leading by example. Unfortunately, just lost her line of touch. She missed the Beijing Olympics due to a neck injury. In London, she could only do the balance beam, and she was injured in training. Had daughter Lena in 2015. Came back 11 months later to win the floor gold at the Mersin World Cup in this very place. She's won a fair few balance beam honours here as well. Really did attack the dismount. Göksu Çıtaşan was a gold medalist on the balance beam at the Islamic Solidarity Games in Baku in 2017. So the action continues with Romania and Silviana Sviringu on the uneven bar. She's got a 12.266 for this in qualification. Did lose her form, and when you lose your form you often lose your swingfulness as well. A remarkable story is Sviringu's, when she became the first Romanian junior to win the senior all-around national championships in 2018. She was just 14. So the Hungarian team competing on the balance beam. Team that was in third place coming into this rotation, trailing Ukraine by just 0.4 of a mark. Sofia Kovac scored 11.766 in qualification. This is where Hungary had some quite pronounced difficulties in qualifying. She has been winning balance beam competitions lately. National championships and the Masters championships. There's a lot packed into that. Mounting a real challenge is the team from Hungary. Last medal they won at the European Championships, the emotional gold on vault from Boglárka Dévai in Glasgow. It's an 11.766 for Göksu Çıtaşan. Not able to really gain much from qualification, just a couple of tenths. It might have been hopeful Turkey of picking up a little bit more there. And we've got some scores to bring you updates on. So Anastasia Motak, 13.033. She's up by a few tenths from qualification. More on that in a moment as we look at Aneta Holosova, the European Games silver medalist on the floor exercise. It's a very fine performance. Had a few difficulties here and there with some of the tumbling passes. Aneta Holosova, she's a captivating athlete to watch on the floor. Has a real sense of performance to her. A couple of the landings just hopping out of bounds. Now it's 12.533 for Zofia Kovac. On the balance beam, that's a gain of almost a mark. Croatia's Ana Jerek competing on the floor. She scored 11.433 in qualification. The 22-year-old, who is the reigning national champion on the floor exercise. Fifth European Championships for her. She is, of course, best known for her work on a couple of pieces, floor and balance beam, and she scored 11.166, so down by a few tenths from the qualification score. Now, that's going to give us an opportunity just to take stock of what we've seen. Magdalena Kufalova, 11.466 for her. So a loss of 3 tenths from qualification. We are seeing a few tenths drop here and there for some of these gymnasts. That's going to be an interesting score to take note of. 9.8 for Stanciulescu on the uneven bars, a 12.5 in qualification. I'm sure you remember the one-mark lead that was being enjoyed by Romania at the start of the rotation. Varinska 13.233 on the uneven bars, up by not far off a mark from qualification. Anastasia Baczynska, score of 12.833, up by a mark and a half. Silviana Sviringu, 12.166, down by a single tenth from the qualification score. Right, I'm sure you've got the hang of all of that. Let's just bring you a couple more numbers. 11.833 for Holosova. She is up from her scoring qualification. Whether it's possible for Turkey, Czech Republic and Croatia to chase any of these nations down, we shall find out. On the subject of chasing down, look at the top of the leaderboard, and what a turnaround that is. Ukraine have eaten up the mark, and they've added three as well. And suddenly, they are in complete and utter control. Now, that has led us to a fascinating halfway point of this competition. Is it that Ukraine have got things locked up? Well, the top group now heads to balance beam. Nothing surprising ever happens on there. So let us not count chickens before they are hatched. And just a brief moment of calmness here in the Mersin Gymnastics Hall, which was built for the Mediterranean Games of 2013. Czech Republic and Croatia make their way across to the vault. Gap has grown between the top two and third place. Hungary are now almost sitting in their own little medal category. Whether they can chase away and challenge Romania, who are currently in second place, we shall find out in due course. Hungary do conclude their competition vaulting, so they may feel, as long as they can just get to the final rotation in touching distance with a mark or two, they'll be happy with that. Well, I'm sure you didn't expect this women's team final to be a routine, mundane, and by-the-numbers affair. We have a look at what could be a very important performance. This is Daniela Trica of Romania on the balance beam. This is all that we expect her to be doing in this team final. She is a real specialist on this piece. Was a silver medalist at the national championships last month. She has only been a senior for around about half a year or so. Has been training at the National Olympic Centre for about 4 years. Started her training at the CSS Bielad Club in her hometown. Well, it's time for Romania to really now be steady hands on the balance beam and make a chase for this. Just about. Did rather lose the form, particularly in the back leg. It is fair to say that one can feel the nerves here. And she is through the routine. Daniela Trica of Romania. There are some clear deductions to be calculated for losses of form. We will return to the balance beam in due course. We'll now head to the vault and a look at Czech Republic, represented by Magdalena Kufalova. .966, down just a tenth from qualification. She was the junior national champion on vault last year. Turkey, who currently find themselves in fourth position, where they were at the end of the first rotation. Representing them is Cemre Kendurca. She scored 12.033 in qualification. Certainly appears that Cemre Kendurca is increasing in confidence as the competition goes. And we expect this to be the final performance from her. She's not down to do vault as things stand. Though she was the Mediterranean champion in Cagliari last year on the vault. Slightly different reactions from teammates. 12.466, Daniela Trica, down by 0.4 from her score in qualification. At the moment, the numbers, to put it gently, are not favouring Romania. Long way to go. Anastasia Motak scored 12.733 in her qualification performance. National champion on the balance beam. This is a real test of a young athlete through that difficult sequence. Okay. Well, it took a while, didn't it? Looked as though she'd saved herself, but that was very difficult to arrest. Step forward as she lands. The deduction as well for exiting the apparatus early. We'll come back to that as we look at a very consistent display there from Cemre Kenduja, 12.033 on floor. Exactly as she performed in qualification. Really nice to see her deliver the sort of display that we knew she could in this competition. Now Petra Furac of Croatia competing on vault. She scored a 12.5 in qualification. Gymnastum Karlovac had a lovely moment where she won Athlete of the Year in her city for the fourth time in a row this year. Mertil Makovits of Hungary now to compete on the floor exercise. 11.733 was her qualification score. Makovits, a gymnast who, like a lot of juniors, benefited from a little bit of time away from the sport a couple of years ago to decide that it was really what she wanted to do. And apologies, I think you heard a combination of her floor music, someone else's floor music and no floor music there, which didn't make life particularly easy. It's 11.833 for Anastasia Motak on the balance beam. So what we've just seen there is Romania just take away around about three quarters of that mark. Three quarters of a mark that they had needed to chase down. Three marks in total. And we look at Bilge Tahan, 12.166 for this in qualification. One has to remember when looking at a gymnast like Bilge Tahan, when looking at most of the Turkey squad, they are gymnasts who are really starting their journey as senior athletes, and that was promising work. Now we go to the balance beam, where the real drama in this competition is unfolding. Anastasia Baczynska looked like she was heading off the apparatus. Silviana Sviringu scored 12.366. Much more settled now. Well, Ukraine, yeah, absolutely. Oh, she's just said what I was going to, but in a far more eloquent way. We'll leave it at that. Bilga Tarhan, 12.033. Darina Bürtsager of Hungary, very experienced athlete competing on floor, the 28-year-old. It is remarkable to think that she had shoulder surgery and only started training again in August. Graduate of physical education and sports science. Made a big move, Darina Bürtsager, a couple of years ago when she switched clubs. Come back to that in a little while. Now Baczynska, 12.7, down by a few tenths from her scoring qualification, but we're now starting to get more concerned with what kind of cushion Ukraine are building up. Larisa Yordaki scored 13.633 for this routine in qualification. If she can get that number here, if. Was the champion in 2013 on the balance beam. That's big work, and it's great work. And there's such elegance and style to that walkover. Simple things done well too. Yes, indeed. First international competition for 3 years, and the years roll back as Romania starts to believe again. Their last team title, 2014. They needed a big performance there from Jordache, and they may just have got it. Really, one simply has to watch the work of Göksu Uçtaşan on floor in Mersin, because she's won so many gold medals over the years in this very building. She will compete in the floor final. There is a musicality to the way that the 30-year-old performs that can set her quite apart from some of the other athletes that we watch. An assurance. Lots of experience, of course, that she has, but more than that, also a real love of the artistic elements of the sport. What an inspiration she is to them, to these young gymnasts. Hang on a minute, 14.133, the score for Jordache. And she has gained the best part of half a mark from qualification. It's a big number as well. Now to Diana Varinska, who scored 11.966 in qualification. She had some real difficulties. Bronze medalist at the European Games. But as I mentioned earlier, she has been unwell, very unwell. She's found the recovery from having the coronavirus has made everything so much harder. She said training has been twice as difficult. She said, even though she's only been back for a few weeks, never considered not coming here, wanted to be here. Just avoided the hand going down. Is it going to come down to margins that fine? Romania asks the question, Ukraine replies. We have some way still to go, don't we, in this women's team final. The score, 12.533. I'm going to take stock of the numeracy in just a moment. Petra Furac, who we saw earlier on the vault, 12.733 for her. That's up by a couple of tenths from qualifying as Croatia seek to improve upon being the sixth strongest in qualifying. 11.033 for Mirtil Makovic on the floor exercise, and Darina Bertziger, 12.666. That's very consistent. We're going to see her in the floor final tomorrow. This is the work of the experienced vaulter Tiana Corrent. She will be participating in the vault final. This is the only thing that she was expected to do. Marked down by 0.4 from qualification, 13.433. 12.033. It might well be that we see from Göksu Uçtaşan a little more difficulty in the final. Okay, well, all that has changed things a fair old amount going into the final rotation. Goodness me, this one is up and down like a yo-yo at the moment. Ukraine, 117.031. Romania, 115.897. They've got the gap down to a mark and a little bit. Now, Hungary in third place. They are 5.1 marks shy of Romania. So really now Hungary will look over their shoulder rather than looking forwards as they go into the final rotation and look to secure their first ever team medal. But when things started, Romania were a mark up. They then lost their advantage. But it was work on the balance beam from athletes like Silviana Sviringu, we're looking back at her performance now, that has helped the Romanian team to just remove a little bit of that buffer zone that Ukraine had of 3 marks, down to just over a mark. So it was a 12.366 for Sviringu. Once again, the reigning all-around national champion. So we go into the final rotation. Turkey and Hungary take to the vault. For Hungary, this is a chance to cement their bronze medal. Because they do need to make up over 5 marks to receive a silver. Croatia and Czech Republic, they're taking to the uneven bars. Kristina Zvicka will be performing in that rotation. She is in the uneven bars final. But this is where the title will be decided on the floor exercise. Romania and Ukraine. We start with Diana Varinska. It's now time to decide who's going to take this one. Will the dreams indeed be sweet? Are they made of performances like this? Whoever you're supporting in this final, you can have nothing but the greatest of respect for an athlete like Diana Varinska, who has been really up against it to get to this competition. Ece Yavuz of Turkey vaulting. And unfortunately for her, not able to match the 13.4 that she delivered in qualification. I hope that she's okay. It looks as though she is evidently in a fair bit of discomfort. It's a great shame to see in an athlete, especially when they're making their senior international debut. Came in as a late replacement for Nazli Savranbashi. So a slightly quiet atmosphere as a result of what we've just seen here. Just have another look back at it. She's got the legs a little bit crossed, and as she lands, really does compress down onto the front part of the foot. Sabina Halova from Czech Republic on the uneven bar. She scored 11.5 in qualifying. She won this event at the trials for the European Championships back in March. Simple work, but assured work from Sabina Halova. Czech Republic have no individual finalists competing tomorrow. Now to Antonia Duță of Romania on floor, only competing on this piece. She was fourth on the floor at the Junior European Championships a couple of years ago. Well, there was some very assured tumbling there from Duță. She twists with very strong form. Really going for height with the leaps. Some of her closer work to the apparatus was perhaps not quite as effective. Had a little bit of deviation of the x-axis on her wolf turns. Bilge Tahan, this was her finest work in qualification, 13.3 for her vault. And it will likely be a similar story here in the final. Vault silver medalist at the National Championships in March, her first senior medal. And now part of this Turkish team competing for the first time in a women's team final at the European Championships. Now the score for Diana Varinska, we're going to see now, 12.466. So what will be interesting is when we get the score in for the first Romanian gymnast to compete on floor, Antonia Duță, we'll have an idea of what that means for the final standings as we have a look at Dorina Bertsiger vaulting. 13.3, a very helpful number for Hungary in their quest to secure this bronze medal. It's a 13.266 for Tarhan. That's really consistent work from her. 13.3 in qualification, as I mentioned earlier. This could be a big performance. Angelina Radivilova, real specialist on the floor. Does some difficult tumbling. The reigning national champion on the floor exercise. They brought her out for this big performance. She will compete in the floor final. Will it be a big enough number? Has real amplitude in her tumbling work. Had a little loss of stability in some of the landings, which will carry some execution deductions. We head to Dilara Yurdaş, who will be representing Turkey in the vault final. She scored 13.466 for this performance in qualification. And she is the reigning national champion on the vault. 16-year-old comes from the Konak district of Izmir, the same part of the city as Ferhat Arujan. And there's been some very stable vaulting going on from Turkey. Good toe point for the majority of that vault. A decent line centrally as well down the tramway. Now, just to let you know, the score for Antonia Duță was 12.8. What that means is that 0.334 of the deficit has been eaten up. It means that Ukraine now have a 0.8 advantage from 1.134. The next gymnast to try to mount an attack on that will be Ioana Stanciulescu. Junior European champion on the floor in 2018 in Glasgow, the reigning national champion, 13.066 in qualifying. It's going to be close. We really are in for a nail-biting finish to this women's team final. Memel turn moving into the illusion turn. Not so tidy with parts of that sequence, particularly the transition. Judges looking for all of those irregularities of form in the tumbling passes as the Romanian team do what I'm sure many of you are doing at home, which is just screaming loudly and throwing things in the general direction of the television. Again, very consistent, 13.466, exactly as Yurtdash scored in qualifying. We'll take a break from the floor exercise now to head to the uneven bars. Czech Republic and Aneta Holosova going for real height with her first release and regrasp. Builds up the swing, didn't quite get the angle right, I think, as she was heading off the apparatus there into the layouts. As a result, just a little loss of form. A very accomplished vaulter for Hungary, Csenga Bacskoy. Youth Olympic Games silver medalist in Buenos Aires, 13.3. She will be competing in the vault final. Now we have a number in for Angelina Radivilova. The number is 12.633. Radivilova is down by about 0.4 from qualification. Haven't yet got the score confirmed for Ioana Stanciulescu. So we go to Yelizaveta Hubarieva. It's a 13.033 for Stanciulescu. I'll let you get the calculators out in a moment. Silver medalist on the floor exercise at the National Championships in September. 16-year-old from Donetsk. Watching on the experienced Angelina Radivilova. Now, Zofia Kovac to vault. .14.2, certainly a leading contender for glory in the vault tomorrow. She will be participating in a couple of finals, and that score will do the absolute world of good to the gymnast from Hungary. Well then, shall we finish as we began. And this began some time ago. Her story, full of some extremely difficult chapters for her to have written and for her to read back. But if she is to be successful at these European Championships, then it will be a book that has been worth writing. The gymnast who was part of the Romanian team that won the title in 2012 and 2014. We're waiting on the score for Elizaveta Hubiareva. But we now see as 12.533 is registered for Hubiareva. So about a 0.4 advantage is what Ukraine is defending as we head into this routine. She couldn't, could she? It is quite simply the most remarkable conclusion to this women's team final. And it had to come from her, didn't it? Larisa Yurdaki. The score required 12.933 plus. And it will be the title for Romania. The gymnast who's had three surgeries on her Achilles. A gymnast who said not so long ago it was 50-50 as to whether she would even perform again, whether she would ever take to the floor. Well, it's in the balance now, but it's in the balance in a different way. It's the kind of 50-50 that she's used to and the kind of 50-50 that she tends to come out on the winning side of. There we have confirmation of the 12.8 for Antonia Dudza. That was the one that took the advantage down from 1.134 to 0.8. Then Radivilova and Stanciulescu got the advantage for Ukraine to 0.4. So already three quarters of a mark removed. Now she waits for the final score to come in. Is it Ukraine? Is it Romania? This is agony, but it's a better kind of agony. A better kind of agony than she's used to. Three of them look quite relaxed. I'll make that 2.5. I think Radivilova's got a little bit more nervous now. Watching and waiting. It's come down to the final score. Hungary also part of this journey. Waiting for confirmation of their place on the podium. As things currently stand, Hungary are sitting in the silver medal position. It's Ukraine, Hungary, Turkey, but we do have this Romania score to come in, and a reminder that they're looking for a score of 12.933, and I think you can see that the numbers have favoured Ukraine. And it is close. It is very, very close. Hungary, the bronze medalist, I think they've just realised that now. We'll bring you the exact number just as soon as it's confirmed. And it's showing up at the moment as a 12.766 for Jordaki. So there we go. Ukraine, 154.663. Romania, 154.496. What an absolutely extraordinary finish to this competition. The gap, 0.167. Well, the Romanians have got themselves a medal in any case, and for many of these athletes, it is the very first one. Not for Jordaki, but she is back on the podium once again, and the tears flow because Romania have returned to a European Championship team podium. And what about Ukraine? For the first time ever, they are the champions. Two-time silver medalists, but no team medal since 2004. And for Hungary, their very first ever. They were eighth in Glasgow, eighth in 2016 in Switzerland. Well, the Ukrainian team have done exactly what the men's team did, which is come in as the second strongest in qualification and walk away with the gold medal. Hungary will take their place on the podium in just a short while as well. And let's just take a moment to look back at some of the action from this women's team final, a team final that was separated in the end when it came to gold and silver by less than 0.2 of a mark. Can you believe it? It was a women's team final that kept us guessing from start to finish. The early pace set by Romania. They then had difficulties on the uneven bars, and Ukraine picked up a massive advantage. They almost lost that advantage. They held on by 0.167. And we will have in just a short while the victory ceremony for this women's team final. Turkish team finishing in fourth place in their home championships. Some signs of real promise from some of these young athletes. And it has to be a glorious moment for her, for Angelina Radivilova, her biggest honours. The 2011 Universiade, she was a team silver medalist there and a bronze medalist on the uneven.